Agilent Slim's version 6.6 includes a new module and quality of life improvements for workflows, configuration sharing, history, and more. This highlights video targets four of our most interesting upgrades: the status workflows module, reference data accessibility, history changes, and updates to the Slim's share module. The status modules in previous versions were combined into one, the new status workflows module. Several default status workflows exist to support standard statuses for various record types, such as content, orders, instruments, and more. Likewise, all possible statuses and status transitions were moved into this module to support your instance, whether you are upgrading or starting from scratch. These tabs allow custom status workflows to be created. Status workflows are tied to particular records by way of a new status field. These samples have been set up to use a custom status workflow instead of the default content workflow. There are many options on status transitions that affect the mobility of records between various statuses. They affect which users, roles, or groups can execute a status transition, which transitions are available in a status workflow, and which status transitions require electronic signatures and/or reasons for change to execute. Statuses likewise affect whether records in a particular status can be edited or deleted, what user, role, or group can edit or delete them, whether records in a status are active or inactive, and whether the records that use the status workflow are versionable. Custom publication status workflows can be created to support any needs you have for versionable records outside of the default versioning systems. Status workflows can be exported and imported using SlimShare to easily use your custom status workflows across all your instances. Depending on the field setup, users with the appropriate role access rights can view the details of reference data records next to the field on the form. If reference data records are missing from the field, they can be added right from the dynamic choice dropdown if the field is set up to allow it. Updates to history grids were made to improve readability, traceability, and expand compliance options. The first of these is the expansion of related events that are captured in history grids. This means more events are captured than before, but views can be used to filter for the records that you want to see events for. By the way, you can right-click and choose the history action for instruments, orders, records, and so on now, not just for content. Another of the most pervasive history changes involves time zones and date formatting improvements to provide a more consistent experience for users. The History Language Lab setting sets the language that all the instances' history metadata is displayed in, regardless of the user's selected language. Additionally, the History Date Format Lab setting will set the date and time zone format of changes in history grids. While we focus on dates and times, date and date time fields now respect the user's time zone, but time fields are recorded exactly as they are entered by the user. If the workday starts at 900 in America, then it shows us 900 in Switzerland as well. History grids split into two columns to show when the change occurred in the user's time zone and in UTC time. These respect the History Date Format Lab setting. Many-to-many fields are easier to understand in history grids now. They are represented by a grid in the Changes column that shows updates in blue, additions in green, and deletions in red. Finally, in the Users module, the Full Name field was added, which automatically concatenates the user's first and last name fields. Slim's does this even if the user's name data is coming from a third-party authentication method, whenever possible. There are new rows in history grids to help differentiate between various actions, such as authentication events, comments, and descriptions. The Slim's Share module has been optimized for ease of use and understanding. Some changes relate to the new Installed Packages tab, which adds a grid that displays all the packages installed on the Slim's instance. The Installed Packages tab exposes details about packages that were already installed, so you can see where they came from, who installed them, what the package version was, and whether they were completely installed. If an installed package has become outdated, the Version button opens the Create Package tab with the new version ribbon, so that Slim's engineers or super users can create a new version of the package on the spot. Some changes apply to the whole module. The entity names are displayed as user-friendly names instead of the development names. The package export options have moved into the top bar, where they are condensed into a pop-up after clicking on one of the export options. Workflow packages cannot be exported to file. Thank you for watching our latest feature highlight video. Subscribe to the channel to see future tutorials, highlights, and news, and check out our website for further product information with the link in the description.